Overseer's log, town of Flatwoods. My God, there's no one here. The old tavern, the church, people were using them for shelter, but they're gone. Mutations we expected. But there's something else, a disease. I was attacked by, well, it used to be a person. But it had these green, glowing lesions, and its voice, angry, tortured. We are one. One what? Whatever happened here is beyond anything we expected. And we expected a lot. Before they were wiped out, the survivors called themselves the Responders. Looks like they were made of firefighters, police, emergency medical staff. They even have an automated system to teach people about treating water, food, survival. I'm doing their tests, and you should too. I know it's even worse than we imagined, but someone's got to know where the missile silos are and how to secure them. The Responders are the best lead we have. This is the Overseer, signing off.
Great War now. It's not been long, and things have been rough. Welcome to Survivor Stories. I'm Dasa Ben-Ami, a Responder. I've been working with the Responders for a couple years now. I'm from Charleston originally, so it was easy to join up. What wasn't easy was the work. Rebuilding Appalachia from the rubble while survivors flock to us regularly from all over. So many have come and gone. Their stories untold, their names lost to time. If you need support, I thought we should preserve this history somehow. I've decided to ask people to record their thoughts, their stories, anything they want to preserve forever. I'll call this series the Survivor Stories. I'll start with me. I was an anthropology PhD student at Vault Tech University, final year. I was printing my thesis when I heard the sirens. I thought for sure my father, a Vault Tech employee, could take us all with him, but only two reservations came through. I refused to go. With my little brother, he went to the vault. They could not persuade me, though they tried. In the end, I pushed them inside it, and that was it. After that, I went back home to Charleston and, well, survived. Eventually, the responders formed, and I signed up right away. It was so hard. The flood was devastating. Relocating to Morgantown Airport and now Flatwoods has been... I remain optimistic. Been with them now for, I guess 2 years. We have big plans. We can do so much to help. Maybe, just maybe, we can rebuild enough to be okay. And in the meantime, I will continue to record stories of survivors when I can. We are your history. This is Dasa Ben on me, signing off for now.
Hi. Dasa asked me if I would talk about, how I got here. She asked everybody, so I said okay. My name's Colonel, and I'm 13 years old. I just wanted to say I'm sorry. I'm sorry for everything. The bombs and the messed up people and the cows with two heads, all of it. I was bad. Just bad. I cheated on my spelling test. I kicked Chip Wilkins in the shins until he cried. I pushed Rosie McCloy down the stairs. I cut holes in the bottom of all the gym shorts and I put glue in the mashed potatoes in the cafeteria. I told Harold Newell to eat 10 dead flies a day in order to grow muscles, and I put Nuka-Cola in the rat cage water bottles at the pet store. And, I just wanted to say I'm sorry about everything. Because my dad said if I wasn't this way, the bad things wouldn't happen. I haven't seen Daddy since the bombs, and I guess he left because of that, too. It's okay. I'm trying to be good now, though. I'm not old enough to be a volunteer, but Dasa said I could help collect food and water, so I'm getting better, I promise. And, Daddy, if you're listening, I promise I won't be bad anymore, so you can come back now. Okay?
Sure is great to see living human beings again.
くそ。面白いじゃねえか、ボルトだな。ホラーと76。
our stories. For posterity, you know. It seems like a fine idea. So, hi. I am Kesha McDermott. When the bombs fell, I was in Watoka, coordinating a statewide science fair for that year's high school kids. And the theme was the future of energy. After the bombs, everything was pretty chaotic. Scavenging for food and fighting off rabid survivors. Oh, it was just a bad time all around. I found a couple of surviving kids from the high school whose parents didn't make it. And we holed up in a house in town for a while. After a bit, I was able to solder the circuitry in an old radio, and we tuned in to a broadcast from the responders. Oh, we were overjoyed. The trip from Watoka to Flatwoods, it was rough, mind you. The kids and I ran into a group of assholes in the mountains who stole our food and water. I can't tell you how happy I was to find the responders in Flatwoods. Tents for everyone, open kitchens, medical supplies, protection. We were safe. They had a problem, though. Their water sources were contaminated heavily. People were boiling water, but not long enough to make it safe. So, I stepped up and I said, I'll build a testing kit to monitor the contamination and I will teach folks how to properly boil water. And I did. The world is getting better, but slowly. We need to make sure it doesn't relapse too. It's going to take time and care, that's all. Well, time, care, and science.
Thank you. So, hi. My name is Scott Shepherd. Things are going all right. I was a nurse before the war, and I guess nothing much has changed. I just work for the responders now, and I don't get paid. The government is basically the same now as it was years ago. Wrecked. Disorganized. Cannot be trusted. Everyone knows this. You want to know why the war actually happened? Aliens. You think I'm joking? Listen. Now right before everything went to hell, I saw them. I was grilling hamburgers out in the yard with my dog, and I heard rustling from the bushes and a zapping noise. Next thing I know, I'm lightheaded and I felt myself falling to the ground. And I didn't even have a lot to drink. I woke up and I saw some little thing run into the bushes with my dog following it. And I knew something was wrong. I found my dog later with a clump of green skin in his mouth. Green! Like moss or something. The bombs fell almost 10 days later. 9 days, 19 hours to be exact. That's 235 hours precisely. You know what that is, right? That's right. The atomic number of the fissile isotope of uranium. They had a plan from the very beginning. Why would they come after me first? Scott Shepherd, the nurse. Well, good question. Glad you asked. They have our blood. They knew which ones of us would survive. This is one big experiment to them. This whole thing was staged. Our lives, our thoughts, everything was designed for us, just like this conversation. Every word I'm saying. Planned. Time to wake up, Appalachia. Find the ones holding the strings and cut the cords.
Source found. Initialize scanning protocol. Ooh.
Tonight, we bring you the final chapter of Who Goes There? The Strange Encounter in Flat Woods. In the last episode, Pioneer Scout Fred Fisher met a curious girl named Sally while hiding in the dark. But as it turned out, they weren't alone.
There are other people here?
Yeah, they probably just went to get more food. They'll be back soon enough. You can wait with me, and they'll give you food too. You just have to do what they want.
What do you mean?
When they want to play games with you.
Games? What kind of games?
I'm still learning the rules. Mostly, they're kind of boring and only hurt when they use the needles.
Needles?
Yeah, you know, like at the doctor.
This doesn't sound like any game I know. It sounds downright awful and these people sound really bad. We have to get out of here.
No, stay put, stay put, stay put, stay put!
Okay, stop screaming!
Tales from the West Virginia Hills.
To see living humans. again.
How I got here. She asked everybody, so I said okay. My name's Colonel, and I'm 13 years old. I just wanted to say I'm sorry. I'm sorry for everything. Moms and messed up people and the cows with two heads, not all of it. I was bad. Just bad. I cheated on my spelling test. I kicked Chip Wilkins in the shins until he cried. I pushed Rosie McCloy down the stairs. I cut holes in the bottom of all the gym shorts and put glue in the mashed potatoes in the cafeteria. I told Harold Newell to eat 10 dead flies a day in order to grow.
Overseer's Log, town of Flatwood. My God. There's no one here. The old tavern, the church, people were using them for shelter, but... mutations we expected. There's something else. A disease. I was attacked by... Well, it used to be a person. But it had these green, glowing lesions and its voice. Angry. Tortured. But what? Whatever happened here is beyond anything we expected. And we expected a lot. Wiped out. The survivors called themselves the responders. Looks like they were made of firefighters, police, emergency medical staff. We even have an automated system to teach people about treating water, food, survival. I'm doing their tests, and you should too. I know it's even worse than we imagined, but... got to know where the missile silos are and how to secure them. The responders are the best lead we have. This is the Overseer, signing off.
To the responders for their outpost here, and you're welcome. The responders are on a true mission, you see, helping folks through thick and thin, till the heavens open up again and take us all up anyways. When this all happened, I figured like most, it was time. this was the end. But it wasn't, was it? We're still here. At first, I thought it was a mistake, that we was missed, forgotten. Maybe we did some wrong. Didn't give enough to charity, maybe. Didn't praise his name, even in the worst of times. Maybe thought some things that ought not to have been thought. So I asked him. I asked how? Why? I fought your wars on Earth. I'm ready to fight them up there by your side. Then, in my despair, I saw some survivors eating raw rat carcass behind the dumpster. You gotta cook that first, I warned them. Seemed obvious. We tried but got sick, they said, covered in their own filth. I realized right then and there that I was being tasked. From then on, I built kitchens, cooked good food, fed anyone who walked up with an empty belly. And I was thankful for my task in life. Thankful. Next time hell or high water land in my stoop, I'll be swept clear away with it. But till then, let's share a home-cooked meal together, all right?
Necessary for equipment sterilization. Please assist.
Thank you.
Overseers, let's call these personal journals. Not an official log, just something from me. The Agricultural Center, one of my first posts with Vault-Tec. I was so excited because I used to come to this same farm when I was a kid. I remember one year at the Autumn Festival, me running through the corn maze, going every which way, Mom and Dad yelling after me to slow down. Wasn't gonna happen. I guess I was always hitting life fast. Couldn't just be a Pioneer Scout, I had to make troop leader. Couldn't just be a good student. I had to have straight A's. God, I miss those early days. Just being a kid. The three of us, our simple life. Our simple house. I wonder if it's still standing.
some junk?
Thank you.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad. I'm home. I'm sorry it's been so long, but I couldn't get away. I know neither of you is around to hear this, but I miss you. I miss watching Dad grade papers on the living room table. I miss the three of us huddled around the radio, listening to the Silver Shroud. Dad, you were right about what living underground would really be like. 25 years locked in with the same people was a challenge. But watching them pair up, get married, have children, well, I think I got to know a little bit of what you and Mom were always telling me. Well, since I'm doing this whole trip down memory lane, maybe a walk over to the old high school is in order.
Always looking for more help from anyone with a recon scope and an interest in animal behavior. Too bad. If only you had a recon scope, you could assist me in a scientific endeavor.
Ugh!
always use more help in my scientific endeavors.